What is a piston compressor? How does it work? And how do you use it? Hi everyone, I'm Jim. And in this video, I'll tell you everything you need to know about piston compressors, what to look for when selecting one, and the do's and don'ts of working with them. Let's get to it. Piston compressors come in many different types and sizes, but they all compress air, which then runs through different tools. They're used in a variety of industries, and there are many different types, each with their own characteristics. It's important to know how piston compressors work and what the technical differences are between each type. So let's take a closer look. A piston compressor consists of several different parts. The piston rings, the cylinder, the connecting rod, the inlet and outlet valves, and the crankshaft. When the piston moves downwards, the air enters the cylinder through the inlet valve. At the moment the piston is at the bottom dead center, the inlet valve is closed and the maximum amount of air is in the cylinder. The air will be compressed during the way up to top dead center. Just before top dead center, the outlet valve opens and the compressed air is able to go into the vessel. Pressure is measured in bar and PSI, and most compressors can create pressures between 7 and 14 bar, which is enough for many applications. What you'll need all depends on what you want to use the compressor for. So this is one of the factors you'll want to keep in mind when selecting one. What are you looking to do with an air compressor? Are you using it on something around the house or on a specific machine? Let me know in the comments below. And while you're at it, hit that subscribe button and stay up to date on all of our informative videos. Engineers have also developed multi-stage compressors, such as the two-stage type, which have a few advantages compared to the single-stage type. The main benefit is that the multi-stage compressor can reach a higher final pressure. One of the effects of compression is that the air heats up in the process, so the tube can become very hot, which is one of the reasons why we need to handle these things with great care. In single-stage variants, there's one cylinder and one piston which compresses the air in one single chamber. In a two-stage compressor, you have multiple pistons of different sizes. The first stage has a larger diameter than the second one, and a greater amount of air is compressed at a lower pressure. At the second stage, a smaller amount of air is compressed to achieve a higher pressure. On a two-stage compressor, there's a low-pressure cylinder and there's a high-pressure one. Two and multi-stage piston compressors come with a higher efficiency than single-stage piston compressors. The two main types of piston compressors that I'd like to tell you about are the direct-driven and belt-driven compressors. A direct-driven air compressor has a crankshaft that's directly connected to the motor, without any pulleys or belts in between. Because of this, this type of air compressor does not run as smoothly as a belt-driven compressor. They're very affordable, but also pretty noisy, so you'll need to wear hearing protection when the compressor is running. Keep in mind that excessive noise is a health hazard and a disadvantage in some settings. I wouldn't recommend using a direct-driven compressor in your garage or indoors. Belt-driven single-stage compressors are, in comparison, less noisy than direct-driven compressors. So if you plan on using yours on a daily basis and near your neighbors, you might want to consider a belt-driven compressor. They're also quite durable, as you can replace the parts when needed, and they're energy efficient. So, the number of stages in your compressor and whether it's direct or belt driven are important factors you should keep in mind when deciding which one is right for you. But there's another consideration I'd like to talk to you about, and that's the duty cycle. Remember, safety first. So in order to avoid overheating, it's wise to keep in mind what your options are in terms of duty cycle or whether you need a compressor that can run continuously. The duty cycle is the amount of time you can run the compressor continuously, after which it should be left to cool down for a while. If a compressor has a 100% duty cycle, you can run it continuously without any issues. If it has a variable duty cycle of, for example, 25%, you can run your compressor for 15 minutes before you should let it cool down for 45 minutes. A compressor with a 50% duty cycle, for example, will need to be off for 30 minutes after every 30 minutes of activity. There are a few things to consider before deciding which piston compressor is right for you. Pressure rating, either in bar or PSI. The net flow of air, in liters per minute or LPM. And the capacity of the storage tank. It's always best to check the manual of the tool, appliance or machinery you plan to use in combination with the piston compressor, as it should give you some great pointers on all the technical specs you should keep in mind. For an overview of the different types of piston compressors and spare parts, feel free to check out this overview by Kramp. All right, enough about how belt and direct driven compressors work. Let's talk about how to use them. Make sure your compressor is on a flat surface. If your compressor uses oil, the first thing you do is check the oil level. Find the oil sight glass or dipstick near the bottom of one of your compressor's ends and use it to make sure that the oil level reaches the right level on your dipstick, right between the two markers. If your oil level is low, check the owner's manual to see what type of oil you need and pour some into the proper tank. Locate the regulator valve, which should be right next to the smaller pressure gauge on one side of the compressor. Push the hose into the quick release coupling and make sure they're well connected. Connect your tool to the other end of the hose. Make sure the compressor is turned off and then plug in the power cord. Be careful when using extension cords, especially with the more powerful compressors. Ideally, you'd want to plug in the machine directly into the wall socket. To prevent overpressure, some compressors have a safety valve you occasionally need to unplug before you get started. However, you don't need to do this every time you use your compressor, so check the manual to see how frequently you should execute this maintenance task. For now, I'll show you how it's done. The safety valve is usually a plug near the hose and it has a ring on it to make it easy to pull. Pull it and listen for a hiss of air. Then push the valve back in place before starting the compressor. Turn on the compressor and let it pressurize. The pressure switch will stop the compressor automatically when the maximum pressure is reached. Twist the pressure regulator knob and watch the smaller pressure gauge located on the hose until it shows that the pressure is at your desired level. Once the pressurized air is in the hose, you're ready to go. All right, let's talk about servicing your compressor. First, you detach your tool and twist the pressure regulator knob to shut off the air supply. You occasionally need to let out condensation, and you can do this by opening the air tank on the bottom of your compressor. However, check your manual to see what applies to your device. After all moisture is blown out, close the valve. And finally, remember to store your air compressor in a dry, temperature-controlled space. And that's it. We have several other videos you might be interested in, so make sure you like this video and subscribe to the channel. Thanks. Cheers.